How do you control mobile usage and phone addiction? Adults are even more addicted to their smartphone, and you can see these trends all around you. The first thing most people do after waking up is checking their Instagram or reading some sort of an online news. That's where all the problems come from, uncontrolled use. It's the uncontrollable aspect that is that's causing the issues. You can literally create your own echo chambers of information and social groups. It's like social media obesity, access to unlimited amounts of information and calories. That's why you have to make sure that you're the one who's controlling your behavior instead of being controlled by Facebook or your smartphone.
Where's my phone?
It's an addiction like anything else, and the way you overcome this addiction is by creating a certain set of rules for yourself. I like to use the idea of fasting as a metaphor describing this. I myself am creating a lot of content online, and my entire business, podcast, blog, it's on the internet. I need to spend more time on social media and in front of a screen just because it's what I do for a living, and a lot of people are more becoming financially supportive of themselves through online media. However, I'm still very strict about how and when I use these apps. So here's what I do. First, I'm keeping my smartphone on airplane mode 80% of the day. I only turn it on when I actually have to check something, like I'm gonna download some sort of a new podcast episode, I'm gonna call someone, or I'm gonna deliberately start replying to my DMs on Instagram. At other times, I'm quite difficult to reach by just phone. Secondly, all the notifications on my phone are also turned off. No pop-up icons, no attractive looking red numbers on the app icons, no distractive apps on the home screen, and you know, whatever they may be. You wanna keep them all off because they make you more reactive. Whenever you get a blinking sound like bling bling, you're immediately going to get triggered into wanting to check it out. Oh no, it might be important. What if there is an asteroid heading towards Earth and I'm about to die? The truth is that 95% of the time it's irrelevant and just some random noise. The other 4% of the time it may be something important, but it can most definitely wait a few hours. And the last 1% of the time, it's really important, like, yeah, there is an asteroid coming, or there's a nuclear missile heading towards your house, but then there's not much you can do about it either.
Squirrel!
Third, my social media status on all the platforms like Facebook Messenger are also turned off, so I could appear as being offline and invisible. This is again so people wouldn't start messaging me randomly, and yeah, there's this trend of wanting to ask me questions about, you know, hey, like, I'm following the keto diet for a few weeks and I have these problems, this and that, these are my macros, you know, blah, 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 kind of give me some tips, you know. As much as I would like to help you people and give you advice, you know, my time and attention span, they're limited, and I'm not gonna waste my time when I could, you know, make it more productive for more people rather than just you individually. Fourth, I'm also not spending any random pleasure time on social media, like mindlessly scrolling through the news feed or watching all the Instagram stories of other people. It's another form of information overload, and you may feel like you actually need to consume all of the content just because of fearing you're missing out on something. I myself like to think of as a content creator, not a content consumer, and it's very rare when I actually do doze off into the newsfeed. The only time I might do something like that for fun is after dinner when I'm trying to wind down for the night and I've already spent the rest of the day being productive, but at other times it's almost prohibited. Fifth, when I'm working during the day, I made a deal with myself to not check my email or go on social media until I've spent at least a few hours of doing deep work. Deep work is this period of highly focused work with zero distractions. I literally wake up, do my morning routine, then go in front of my computer and start working for hours, whether to edit videos, write articles, or something else related to my business. This is your most precious time period where you're supposed to do your best work. It doesn't have to be in the morning right after waking up, but if you're trying to accomplish any goals or improve yourself as a person, then you need to teach your brain to do deep work without getting distracted. It's really scary. It's neuroplasticity. If you condition your brain to check social media, react to every notification you get on Messenger, and you're gonna be distracted, then you're making your brain become more distracted in the future. You're teaching yourself to become more distracted and addicted to these kinds of things.
Stop it!
Instead, during deep work, you have to literally be so deep in the zone that everything else and the world around you doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if there is an asteroid heading towards you, you have to do your deep work. You have to lose your sense of time and self-consciousness, which is a term called flow. This is how all the most creative geniuses, inventors, and athletes of the past achieved their greatest results. Undisturbed deep work done consistently every day for many hours. Another useful trick for controlling online distractions is to be more busy during the day. Usually, when you do become distracted or absorbed by the news feed, it happens when you get bored and you wanna entertain yourself and, simply give yourself a pat in the back. You take a small break from work and think to yourself, "Oh, I'll just check on Instagram for a minute," and bam, you wasted 20 minutes looking at random stories and pictures. Moral of the story is, pun intended, don't even bother going there if you can't control it. You can maybe use different apps that restrict your time on certain social media platforms like Moment, Off Time, and Break Free, but in my opinion, they're somewhat humiliating ways of restricting yourself. There are also these new habit controlling devices like the Pavlok, which is a bracelet that you can program to monitor certain bad habits and then punish yourself for it by giving yourself an electric shock or something. I mean, I'm not a dog. I'm especially not Pavlov's dog. And humans, we shouldn't need to have these kinds of things as long as we have enough self-discipline and self-awareness. The problem is that most people don't have any self-control, and they aren't even aware of what kind of behavior they're following during the day. Here's where practices of mindfulness, meditation, stress management, and discipline and perseverance, they're so crucial. You want to basically create a mind that's capable of self-monitoring and self-regulating itself in real time, and to always change its operating procedure whenever it's necessary. Whenever you notice that you're starting to get distracted, you acknowledge it to yourself, "Okay, I'm drifting off a little bit." Then you accept it. You don't get frustrated, you don't get anxious. But you'll simply guide your attention back to the task at hand and stay focused like a Jedi again. This way of doing it over and over again is gonna eventually rewire your brain to become more focused and avoid distractions.
Focus.
And lastly, you have to stop seeking validation from these external mediums and other people. It's true, it's interesting to see how other people are living. But most people do it just out of boredom, and they're afraid of missing out on something. You have to find your own purpose in life, and dedicate yourself so hard to it that you don't have time to waste on social media. That's a much more meaningful and more fulfilling way of living than simply scrolling through the news feed or reacting to a random like on Facebook. So yeah, think about it. Positive restriction gives you more freedom. And it's definitely gonna help you to achieve a lot more with your life.
Phone 5.
Body, mind, empowerment.
Get stronger, faster, smarter, quicker, friendlier, more helpful, more driven.
Everything the body needs.
Control your mind.